Spoil. you last night, because when you looked at me, yeah, you couldn't hold my eyes, saying things you never mean. It's no big surprise, telling me that you're the one. I'm tired of the lies. Be the one, be the one who moves my heaven and earth. You wanna be the one who shares my hunger and thirst. You see, the other ones are hanging on, but they've got nothing on you. You wanna be the one, be the one, the only one. I've got no time for bitterness. I wanna move away from this. I found myself somebody who, thank you.
Where do they go and what do they do? They're walking on by. They're looking at you. Some people stop, some people stare. But would they help you and do they care? How did you fall? Did you fall? When you've got nowhere to live. Some turn away so they don't see. I bet you'd look if that were me. the city. We've ever done it acoustically before, have we? Maybe? I don't know. So this is a treat. I love it. It's one of my favourite songs, this, so. Just fine. If the rain crashes down over you, I will love you directly. understand your point of view, letting me go, but I thought you had more faith. Everything I've done for you, you made the mistakes, and now you throw this in my face. And I have worked so hard for you all of this time, and you cast me aside. I understand your point of view, but I can't seem to get my head around all the things that I feel good about always seem to disappear. And every time I think I've got this all worked out, something chews me up and spits me out, but there's nothing left to
I took Thank you. So, yeah, this is a lovely, lovely song. And it's the last one of the acoustic section. So, but then we're going to rock. Yeah! Okay.
Life was before you. I must apologize. Please understand I'm so demanding. Don't need to be cruel. I never felt that with you. Trouble is I'm a danger. Too massive. Don't wanna push you away. I really want you to stay until I figure this out. Won't you?
Change, but I won't let it hold me back. You arrived just in time. Now I know I'll be fine. I am not ashamed to say you truly are my inspiration. Don't need to be cruel. I never felt that with you. Trouble is I'm a danger to myself. Don't wanna push you away. I really want you to stay until I figure this out. Won't you?
Thank you. Yeah. are. Oh. This next song, I know I have on good authority, is a fan's favourite. So here we go.
I never felt alone.
Any good? Okay.
She's gonna end up just like
it's about you and me, and we'll never be the same again.
This is pain. It feels like I'm gone.
Thank you. Been warming you up all night for these next two songs. So this is where you go effing mental, okay? You ready?
The rules, you made me look a fool.
Intuition when you sacrificed your honesty. I believed that you would be there to protect me and help me with all I'm going through. There's a joy to being free that you could have taken from me, but I found the strength to walk away. Yeah. on, you little. It's your own fault. Oh, wow. What an amazing night. It's not over yet. Oh, am I talking too much? Is that my cue to shut off? Do you like that? Huh? So I found a reason to stay alive. Try a little harder, see the other side. Talking to myself, too many sleepless nights. I'm trying to find a meaning to this stupid life.
The sky turns gray and there's no end in sight.
'cause you're the only one who can turn me around when I'm upside down. I turn to you. When my insides are racked with anxiety, what's coming now, don't you? You ready? I want to see some creativity on the dance floor. Okay? It's the last one of the night. Let's give it loads. Thank you, London. Good night. Thanks to my boys, Greg, Nick, Vinnie, Scotty, and Paul. My wonderful crew, Andy. Thanks to Helen. And thanks to everybody. Thanks to Matt. You better be good, you bastard. And thank you to Liverpool Football Club for always being an inspiration to me. And thank you to my manager, Nancy Phillips. And thank you for me mum and dad for having me. Thank you. And thank you to Tom, because I love you.
It's such a big night for me. I'm feeling quite nervous, but I'm very excited. And I feel like the last 7 years of my life, things have changed in both in my professional and personal life. And, you know, I've been very lucky to make 3 albums that I absolutely adore. And tonight feels like I can just get it down for history. My love of music and my love of performing has always been about what we're here doing tonight. It's about the live aspect. It's about getting out there close to the fans, you know, really being able to express yourself and, you know, really perform the songs and really try and explain to people emotionally what you were thinking when you were writing them. So when you see people giving you back that emotion, it's a very special feeling. So it's going to be a big old night, and I'll be quite happy when it's over. We've got some real cheeky characters in the band. I've been working with these guys for quite a while now. In fact, Paul Gendler, my lead guitarist, I've been with him forever. Every single live show I've ever done, he has been there. So that's really nice to have that and to really grow with somebody.
I'll do a solo.
He can be really moody, but he also is really funny, really sarcastic. So he's always very good entertainment and an amazing player, as you will see. We got Vinnie Lammi on drums, who is really good fun. I hate me saying it, but he's more of a girl in the band because he's very caring and he's very considerate. So you go to Vinnie if you want a hug. Have you done anything yet? Oh, good. Because I'm really right.
No.
We've got Greg Hatwell, my rhythm guitarist. We sing When You're Gone Together. He's such a superstar. He is hilarious. He can imitate anybody. He is just so much fun to have around. We call him the excitable puppy because he's the youngest and he's like a little excitable Labrador. Nick joined us when we started work on Beautiful Intentions. We call Nick the Lord because he's posh. He's not really posh, but he's posher than the rest of us. That sounds familiar. Yeah, he's great. He worked with the Manic Street Preachers for a long time. The newest member of the band at the moment is Scotty. And he plays bass, also a great vocalist. And he joined us, he's not really been with us, I don't think, more than a year. But the change in the band has been amazing. You know, musically, he's such an accomplished bass player. And he's Scottish, and he's really big, and he looks very scary, but he's not. He's a pussycat. So, yeah, we have a lot of fun together. Look out, now you know the characters. I've described everybody to you. You see if you can, you can see that in their eyes, a little glint in their eyes. The cheeky one, the naughty one, the moody one. Sounds like a boy band.
It's actually nice and warm, isn't it? I was worried it'd be a bit chilly.
I was beginning to feel quite frustrated with the Spice Girls because everything we did, it was loads of fun, but we really worked as a team and as an individual, I really wanted to express different things, both musically, you know, and there was personal things I really wanted to get out. So I went over to LA and I worked with some amazing people, people like Marius DeFries, Rick Rubin, who's just one of my favourite people in the world. He's such a fantastic producer and I'd adore to work with him again. And Rick Knowles, a great collaborator. We wrote some really great songs together. So it was such a creative time because I just felt free. Oh my God, I'm free. And so many great songs came from that time and it was such a great, for me, a great launch into the world. Northern Star was my first solo album and we're going to be playing some of Northern Star tonight. Always goes down really well in live shows. People love to hear the oldies and reminisce. And I got my first two UK number one singles from that album. So it's a special one for me. Going down. My second album, Reason, again, I recorded in LA, and that was quite a different time. I'd had quite a big personal upheaval in between the two albums. I'd really, you know, had some problems and I was overcoming them. So that was quite a tough album. I kind of was a little bit confused with exactly what I was trying to say. So I don't think it's my strongest album, but I think some of my best songs are on the album. Here It Comes Again is one of my favourite songs of all time. Home, I wrote with David Arnold, who is an amazing songwriter and producer. So it's always, you know, it's good fun to do some of those songs that really, really mean a lot about quite a confused and mixed up time. Beautiful Intentions is my third album, and it's my baby. It's the first album I made on my own label, Regular Records, and that was really, you know, about growing up, standing on your own 2 feet, and it was a big risk, I suppose, financially, but it was a risk I was more than willing to take. You know, the songs on this album came so quickly, and I was so excited, and I just knew that, you know, for me, it was something I'd be very, very proud of forever. We're going to do a lot of songs tonight of Beautiful Intentions. This album is probably more rocky than my first two. I think after doing a lot of live work, I really learned who I was on stage.
This could be the first day of my life.
So this one, I think, is my most exciting, and for me, I think as a piece of work, I think it's my best album. Well, maybe I should say it's my favourite.
So blind that I can't decide if you knew that I had beautiful intentions for you.
Tonight we're working acoustically as well as electrically, and people sometimes ask me which I prefer, you know, because people, a lot of people know I like rocking out, but I love to work acoustically as well. It's a great time to really play with different tones and colours in your voice. And when you can hear yourself a bit better, it really allows you to play around with things like that. When you're rocking out, you're just sometimes you're just screaming. technically, perfectly, of course.
Every day is here to remind me that the past is always behind me. Something I could never change, but I won't let it hold me back. You arrived just in time. Now I know I'll be fine. I am not ashamed to say you truly are my inspiration.
I've played... that sounds really funny to me. I've played with orchestras before, and I've been really lucky. A few times I've played, you know, with full orchestras, which is such an amazing feeling to have, you know, that power behind you of all those instruments. Tonight we're going to be performing with strings, a small quartet, and it's the first time as a band we've worked with live strings. For me, the strings, I like drama, you know, and it's very emotional, and it adds so many colours and layers to the songs. And, you know, on the albums, we have, you know, strings on lots of songs, but to work with them in a live environment is really very special. So that was something I was very, very excited about being able to do for the performance tonight. One of the songs that I'm very excited to perform tonight is Reason. It's a very special song to me. It's got a very personal lyric. But this song I wrote with Peter Vitesse, who is such a lovely guy. I love to work with him. And I was very lucky on Beautiful Intentions to work with him again. He's somebody I feel very, very comfortable with. And I think that's very important. You know, it's funny, when you co-write with people, there's always a different chemistry, and that what I've always enjoyed with working with different people, it just, you know, it brings out different sides of you and different aspects. And I think, you know, with Peter, we always do something very honest and quite beautiful. A new writer that I've been working with, I sang one of his songs on Beautiful Intentions, my first single, Next Best Superstar. Really young guy, he's like 25, Adam Argyle, and he is brilliant. And we have been working together on tracks for my next album, and I've been recording some other tracks that he's written. I feel like he just has, you know, a real sense of who I am and how I want to express myself, and, you know, together we have a lot of fun, and we've written some great songs, and, you know, that's an exciting collaboration for the future. It's just going to be very, very special tonight. I just hope everybody enjoys it and it goes well.
technical, stay out of it.
your sympathy. You just want more. Could be the first day of my life.